Unlimited Ammo here, we're doing Magicite today, and this time we're going to do a walkthrough guide on how to get the Overworld Helmet. Overworld Helmet is the hardest hat to get in the game. You have to get through the entire game without taking any damage. But when you do get it, it reduces all your incoming damage by half, which includes draining down to zero, which can make it a very powerful helmet and it's very fun to use. So what are we going to do to get that? We're not going to do melee combat, because that's very risky. It's a good way to take damage. Do ranged combat, so either have archery or magic. We're going to do archery, because arrows... This is more consistent and easier to use versus magic. You can be very powerful doing magic, but it's a little harder to get started and be less consistent. So we're going to do archery. So I'm taking swift to get bonus dexterity. We're also taking aggressive for bonus attack, because in the first couple levels we're not going to have arrows, so we're going to have to rely on some melee attacks. So this will help us get through the handful of monsters we have to kill in melee more easily. Because we're doing archery, we're taking a dwarf. Plus 4 dexterity, and he starts with the bow. That's perfect, gets bonus damage. We already have our bow, so we can start using arrows right away. Minus 1 HP is pointless, because we're not going to be taking any damage. That's the idea. So Overworld. Hats, I would recommend. The first time I got the Overworld Helmet, I used the bunny ears. That triple jump can really help you avoid taking damage. It's a pretty solid choice. You can also consider Robin Hood hat if you just want to do more damage, so you can kill things before they're much of a threat. I won't recommend this so much. Another recommendation, the one I'm taking, is the miner cap. It gives you bonus ore when you're mining, and you're going to be able to change those bonus ores into bonus arrows, and then you're going to be able to blot out the sun like the army of Xerxes, slaughter all the enemies, and not risk taking any damage at all. That's the idea. That's what we're going for. That's why we're taking the miner hat. Also take the haste beetle. That double damage, or that double speed, can help us get in and out of fights and avoid taking any damage. It's vastly superior to all the other companions for this floaty slime. If you're super pro with floaty slime, I can imagine how this could be useful. I don't like the flying, I think it's hard to use. It's really hard to use it without taking damage. If you insist on going through the overworld as a mage, I'd recommend the Gorgon Eye. That gives you reliable mana regeneration, which you might not otherwise get. Let's just start. And first things first, as usual, get a bunch of sticks. Sticks and wood, and sticks and wood. Need these for tools. Later on you're going to need a huge number of sticks to get arrows. So let's make a pickaxe. So we can start getting stone. We can use that stone to make a stone pickaxe and we start getting iron. We're also going to make a sword. Because we want a melee option right now. Because we don't have any arrows. You see this nonsense down here? These three traps and all these enemies? I'm not going to bother that. Because decent risk, I'll take damage there, and that's what we're avoiding, is taking any damage. So we're not going to do anything risky in this game. We're going to play it very, very passively, not taking any chances. Got some diamond ore from that treasure chest, which is nice. So like this guy down here, he just jumped, and I know how the slimes behave, so it's not much of a chance to go down there. Not much of a risk to go down, punch him. Get a little bit of experience. Experience will help us get more damage to move on, but it's not super important. You don't need to be that powerful in order to actually beat the game. That's why there's an achievement for there's an unlock for beating the game under level 5. It's entirely possible. Later on in the game, this site will terrify me because there's the rock monsters, which you'll all be familiar with, that can look like the iron deposits, and they turn into a giant. Not really giant, they're the same size, but they're terrifying. Turn into these little spiders and they crawl at you and surprise you, and they'll deal damage to you and mess up your overworld run. So when we start getting arrows, we're gonna be shooting arrows at all those deposits. To make absolutely certain that there are real deposits and not a mimic rock that can cause us some serious consternation. We're not gonna miss that wasp nest, because no risks. We're not gonna be taking any risks in this run. We're gonna be getting not hit. My knees, I don't know why that wasp got so upset. Hello, Mr. Wasp, I don't wanna deal with you. Please come at me in a reasonable pace or go away. And this is one reason why the haste beetle is so nice, that we can very easily dance around that wasp. Get more stone. Come on, jump forward so I don't have to hit the wasp nest. Nah, whatever. Oh jeez. Now I really can't hit it again. Come on, slime. And the slimes get next to these traps, and then the timing difference between between the slime jumping and a trap coming up and down can be infuriating. Because he'll jump at the same time that the trap comes down and just bounce off it, and then you can't go in there because the trap's coming back down. We're going to ignore this boar because I don't like I don't like this area for fighting him in. That was super lucky because I missed that jump. You're going to rely on a little bit of luck for this. Sometimes you're going to get trap or enemy spawns that will just make it really hard to get through without taking any damage. More commonly, you're just going to have to just take chances. You're going to have to jump on a rock that might be a monster. You have to go through some traps and hope that there's no ranged enemy on the other side that's going to shoot you. So it does require a little bit of luck. But we're going to try to minimize the reliance on luck. That's what we're doing. Now we only have forest biome to go to. It's kind of disappointing. You should always go to the forest if you're doing an overworld run, because it's the easiest biome, it's the safest. I'm going to try to go through each biome to show you what to watch out for in each one. If that doesn't happen, whatever. I'm not going to worry too much about it. Cook our meat. Make sure you have a supply of food, because you don't want to start starving during your overlord run and then fail because you starved to death. That'd be very disappointing. We don't need our wood. We didn't even use our wooden axe up. We don't need healing items because we're not going to use those. I'll use a little bit of bone to make a bone axe. That way when we use up our wooden axe wreath, we have a replacement. We're also going to make an iron pickaxe. This is very similar to how you'd normally play, just get your resources ready to go and ready to collect more powerful resources. Alright. Then you start collecting gold if you come across it, which isn't particularly likely in the forest. Yep, and now it's level 2, so these rocks can be fake. You have to watch out for that. You see, if you time it right, you can get the arrow to hit the ground at the same time as the enemy, so you'll do damage to the enemy and still get the arrow back. Come on, frames. Game locked up a little bit there for a second. Don't know what happens sometimes. More. Got the downward arrow. Oops, that's a terrible shot. Got the downward arrow attack thing, which is so bad. Because we don't need it. It shoots an arrow straight down. We already have a bow. We can already shoot straight down. We don't need that. It's a pretty bad skill. But we're just gonna have to take it because we already got it. Building up some arrows, which is good. Because we're gonna need them. Hit both of these guys, yes. Good. And again, we can fight this boar in melee combat. It's not a problem, but it's a risk of us getting hit. We don't want to get hit. Ever. We're avoiding that. Alright, shoot that rock, make sure it's real. It is, and we can continue cautiously. Shoot that rock, it is real. This is how you go through each room. You know, check out the room, shoot the most hazardous enemies, shoot any rocks, then go through, gather your resources. And avoid the traps. Do not want to get hit by a trap. It's a very frustrating way to end your run. Being hit by a trap. Especially in the forest. If it's in a dungeon, okay, well, that's unfortunate. You had to go to the dungeon and get hit by those wrecking balls. But somewhere easier, like the forest, that can be very frustrating. Keep our food topped off, don't run out of food. Shoot the rocks, make sure they're real. This boss, I don't know if we have enough arrows. It's pretty weak though. Probably one of the weakest bosses in the game. Hopefully none of these meteors hit us. Nope, we're fine. We can just kill him with our sword. He's very easy to kill. You can, even without the haste beetle, you can just back away from him and take him down with your sword. How much durability do we have on this axe? We have not been using, we're not getting a lot of sticks. Alright. So we'll just kill the slime for a little bit of experience. Get more sticks. Wooden axe is about to break. There's no more trees though, so we're just gonna move on. And I'll show you the swamp. Swamp's pretty easy. There's only really two enemies. There's like a melee Tiki Mask Man, or range shaman Tiki Mask Man. We only got one coal and no stone, so we can't cook this food. It's very disappointing. Might as well sell our almost broken axe. And we do have enough iron and leather or hide to make some armor for us. So we're not gonna do that. Rusted iron will be transformed into arrows. This crafting the arrows, not necessarily transformed. Now increase our damage per arrow, which will be very useful. It'll make our arrows more efficient. We don't shoot as many to do as much damage. Keep those bone arrows in case we need to. Just in case we need to make some bone arrows out in the field. Get a stack of iron arrows going. And alright, that's. We're set to go. Anything worth buying? Nope. On to the swamp. So other than these two guys, in the swamp, you just gotta worry about fake rocks. It's a pretty easy biome. The traps are pretty generous too, these little plants aren't that dangerous. I have no idea what these animals are though. They're like little caterpillars. Like, they're not at all caterpillars. Check for the rocks. Check for the rocks. Okay. Let's check the rocks. I'm gonna say check the rocks like 100 times during this walkthrough, but it's very important. Because you don't want to land on a rock, have it be a fake rock, and you take damage. Just like that rock was there, was fake. If I'm not spamming arrows, I wouldn't have known that. He might have hit me when I approached it. Some more stone. Get more sticks, well, over here. We don't need those sticks for arrows. We have two stone arrows, we'll use this on the Sticky Mask Man. Nope, okay, only need one. Get more stone, make more stone arrows. Copious amounts of arrows. I don't even trust this animal. I don't even trust the animals when you're in Overworld Run. Just kill everything from as far away as you can. Animals don't owe you anything. Alright, get more stones. Check the rocks. Like, that guy was a fake rock. He wasn't even hiding it. He was proud of it. As soon as we saw him, he just came out. Some enemies will aggro when you're below them. So if you see an enemy above you and they're on the ledge, be careful because they might charge down on top of you. We have enough sticks. Okay, number six. There's a range guy down here, he's a hazard. Apparently we kill him in one shot though. Don't mess with vials of poison when you're doing Overworld Run. It's very likely to just hurt yourself. You're constantly crafting arrows. If you don't like crafting arrows all the time, then maybe Overworld Helmet isn't for you. Or you can try doing the mage. Like I said, that's a viable, it's just a little less consistent, a little less reliable. We'll go to the cave next. Should I go to the cave or do we go to the tundra? Let's go to the tundra. Normally I would avoid the tundra and go to the forest, always go to the forest during Overworld Runs. But trying to show you as many biomes as I can, show you how to get through them without being horribly, horribly destroyed. Don't need our melee weapons anymore. Do need to cook the food though. Let's get that going. Get a nice source of food, that way we won't starve to death. We won't fail an Overworld Run because we starve to death. Nom nom nom. Alright, we have enough hide to make an iron armor, which we'll do. We want to increase our damage here. Even though I commonly like to save my hides for a higher level boars, if I'm not confident that I'll have enough. I'm not confident I'll have enough hides later, but for now, going to kind of a dangerous area. There's some threats in the tundra, so I want to be as prepared as possible. Mostly the threats are the fairies that will float around and shoot magic missiles at you. Also the yetis are very tanky, and they'll throw giant snowballs at you. It'll be very painful. They're not very common though. Alright, that's it. Time to move on. Don't have any gold, do we? We have enough gold for one bar, which is enough to do anything with. Alright. Nothing here. Also watch out for the traps. Traps are the snowballs falling from the ceiling. And because they're not constantly there, it's easy just like, if you rush into a room, you might not notice that there's even a trap there. It's very easy to get hit by them. Switch keep an eye. Go slow and keep an eye out for the snowballs. Fairies are fairly squishy. They will shoot you. Check the rocks. Oh, out of arrows. Can't check the rocks. Check some bone arrows. Use this bone up. Check the rocks. Is it real rocks? Something over here. Might even be another fake rock. Go slow, because you gotta watch out for the snowballs. Run to the Yeti. You're probably just gonna run, because they're pretty tanky. These all night guys are a joke. They're easy. Even if you don't have a bow, you telegraph their attacks very badly. So here we have three snowballs coming down. One, two, three in the patterns. Now we go past here. Out of arrows. No, we're not. Arrows, just one shooting. Alright. There's no fairies over here gonna shoot us. Let's go shoot the slime balls and drop down and hurt us. Yeah, check this rock. It's a okay rock. You don't have to. I know you're racially profiling the rocks, which can get kind of boring, but I mean, you gotta do it, otherwise you're gonna get hit by these rocks. Our food topped off. We are missing some health. That's because we've been upgrading our max health, which does not upgrade our current health. It's not because we've actually taken any damage. Get some gold. One shot this fairy. Slime. Look for snowballs. Looks like it's just that one. Okay, wait for it to fall again. Can't be too careful. Sometimes it feels like you're being hyper cautious, but that's a good thing. You need to be hyper cautious. No reason to risk your overworld run or something stupid. Kill you guys. Looks like I kill them all in one hit. I'm not comfortable with the snowballs over here. Alright, so we have two that fall here. One, two. I'm just gonna back up, get the gold, get out of here, wait for this to happen again, and go through. You see, sometimes they fall at different rates, it can be it's a very dangerous trap. Check this rock. Well, I think we were that close, we would have jumped out to attack us anyway. Check these rocks. Nope, that was a fake rock. Always check the rocks, especially if they're in a cluster like that. It's very likely one's not real. And what are we going through the veldt? Looks like we're going to the veldt. Veldt's pretty easy. There's mostly similar enemies. There's the swamp, a little shaman that'll shoot at you, otherwise melee guys. You also have the jellyfish, which aren't that threatening. They behave kind of strangely. Their attack's pretty easy to dodge. Well, we're on a mana potion, so we don't need any more food right now. Alright, we have enough gold for a gold pickaxe, which we'll make right away. We need two bars, only three bars. There you go. And now we can make a bunch of iron arrows. That's where all of our iron can go. Now we have above iron pickaxe and iron equipment. Don't need pelts. Now we're gonna save our gold. Just gold and diamond. Get some more better leather equipment. We have lots of iron arrows. It's very nice. And I still have a root. Right here. That's not important though. Well, like I said, jellyfish are kind of threatening. Their attacks are pretty easy to dodge. And they don't see you from very far. These shaman are probably most threatening because they see you from far away. And they'll shoot their magic missiles at you. The sheep are also massively threatening because there's a ton of sheep and they're always in the way of you trying to shoot the enemy. Don't know why that's how it works, it just is. I'm actually gonna go over here. Shoot this guy. Traps. Are there traps in the veldt? Where are there traps in the veldt? I don't think there are traps in the veldt. That makes it a pretty safe biome as well. Unless the copious amounts of sheep that block your arrows are considered the trap. Okay, that's a safe rock, so we can just go down here, surely shaman. Beautiful. Like I said, it's a safe rock. Let's see, go ahead and mine it. Need more sticks? Okay, I need more sticks. I don't care if he's just sheep, I'm gonna shoot you anyway. Don't wanna deal with any sort of risks. I want there to be a wolf and sheep clothing here. Most of them shooting them in case there's something happens, I need to maybe kite back. That way I don't have them blocking my shots. So jumping mushrooms can be kinda dangerous. Every time they shoot, they slide back a little bit. So we're gonna let them slide back off the ledge so I can shoot them more easily. And get up here and shoot this guy. Really easy. Alright. Horde of monsters here, we just gun them down. Keep an eye out above you for range enemies because you don't want any surprise shots from above you. Num num num. Alright. Spray the hallways. Check the rocks, move slowly. Make sure you're not surprised. You don't want to be surprised. Getting lots of resources is very nice. And we're going to the dungeon. The dungeon's extremely dangerous. You always want to avoid going to the dungeon. But as I said, I want to show you all the biomes. And if you're going to fail, if you have to go to the dungeon, then if you're going to fail a overworld run, it's going to be in the dungeon. Dungeon's absurdly hazardous. Some people think it's easier than other people. I think it's very, very hard. And we don't have enough gold or diamond to do anything with. Kind of sad, so we'll just make more iron arrows. No, those are bone arrows, okay. These are iron arrows. So dungeon has a ton of hazards, mostly the wrecking balls. Traps are absurd. Other than that, you have these genies. They have a decent amount of health, and they will shoot 3 fireballs at you and then fly towards you. And then these really weak skeleton archers that will snipe you, they'll shoot you, their arrows actually travel through walls and stuff, so it's easy for them to hit you. Other than that, you have these absurdly dangerous wrecking balls everywhere. And these archers, and these tanky minotaurs. And it's just overall a nightmare house. Alright, there's nothing in that treasure chest. So normally when you go through a dungeon, you get a bunch of rewards, a bunch of experience, a bunch of cool items. We're not worried about that. We're not worried about items, we're not worried about treasures. We're just trying to get through this alive. By alive, I mean not taking any damage at all. It's going to take a lot of concentration, it's very risky. If you can dodge all the traps, you're really well set. Just gotta be patient, take your time. Don't go out of your way for things. Like, I would like that rock, we're not going to even bother trying to get it though. Down there all the way in all those traps, I don't know. Do not want to even attempt it. Keep our food topped off. We'll check if there's any enemies over here. There's an archer, so we're gonna take him out. We also only check the rock. Miss archer though. I think that's 2 archers on top of each other actually. Alright. Experience. Level up, got the fire wisp, that's very nice. Let's put a little wisp out there that does shoot an arrow and double our damage. Hopefully there's no archers or genies, okay. Very, very risky over here. Oh shit. I mean, yeah. My bad. Take out the charge chest, because it's a mimic. Check this rock, safe, move on. Dungeon's very stressful. It's pretty unfortunate if you have to go into it while you're doing your overworld run. But sometimes it's just how the game operates. It will usually force you to go to a difficult biome, which is the dungeon or the volcano. But the volcano is way easier. It's a very much easier biome to deal with. Not nearly so stressful. So I don't deal with any of this, we're just gonna get out of here. I don't mess with any of those archers. Is that archer gonna shoot me? I really hope not. Don't mess with any of those archers, don't mess with those minotaurs, don't mess with those rocks or anything. Because we don't take any damage, we're just trying to get out of here. Oh, hit the mimic, please. Okay, I really want those though. Let me already check the rock. So it's all set. And this guy's gonna shoot us. And we're gonna junk. Get over here. Pick up the leather. Shoot the archer. Okay, now we're set. Now we just have to take out the genie. And we're good. And the genie's being merciful and not seeing us. Take this genie. Okay, and next we're going to the forest again. We'll stick to the easiest pass we can get. So that's it. If you have to go to the You have to go to the dungeon. Don't worry about big rewards. I mean, they're there, but that's not what you're there for. You're just trying to get through without taking any damage. So if you get cool stuff like Luminous Leather, that's great. If not, that's fine too, as long as you don't take any damage. But the good thing about this is that we can make actually a full set of leather armor. Fantastic. Where's our... where are you at? We shouldn't even need that much leather because we have picked up two right there. That's one piece of armor. 1, 2, 3. And we have enough for a leftover, leftover pickaxe. So that was actually a very lucrative dungeon. If I knew it was that lucrative beforehand, I probably still wouldn't go in there because I don't want to risk taking the damage. We're doing an overworld run. So that means we don't need any leather hides anymore. We have a full suit. Turn these two into blades, pickaxe. Oops, that's not a blade. Alright, now everything else is arrows. Arrows, arrows, arrows. I don't like the bone arrows because they look identical to the iron arrows. More arrows, we need more wood. We're going to the forest, so of course there's plenty of wood in the forest. Alright, lots of arrows. What's this? Oh, we can sell this root we have still. We'll get our food, get our fill before we forget. And move on. We're still gonna be super careful. I know, like, we're a lot stronger now, we can kill everything in one hit. We still gotta be careful. Slow and careful. So we don't run into any fake rocks. We don't want to get hit by any traps. We don't need bees to go crazy and shoot us. I don't even trust you being behind me. I want that experience though. Fake rock? Real rock. Fake rock. I think it's real rock. It's real rock. Can't be too careful. And we need sticks. I want to get some sticks too over here. It's a real rock. Wait for this trap to go by. That is a penguin. That is a very large penguin. So what we're going to do, we're going to put our little wisp out, and we're going to shoot it, because it's in our way. I don't want to bother getting around. It's actually easier to kill it. I think it's a little less risky to try to kill it. So it won't actually engage with us yet. And just forward carefully. Mostly looking out for boars and fake rocks. Those are our biggest hazards here. There's a boar, if we don't see it coming, it can ruin our day. There's some gold over there. I don't want to bother going back to try to get it, because I don't want to backtrack through traps. Shoot you, you're done. Careful here. Do want that rock though. Gotta check it's fake though. It's not. Imagine if it is fake, we jump up there, do a cool dodge move to dodge a trap, and then all of a sudden we get hit by a spider. Gotta be careful, we're just gonna dodge this room. And another penguin. So we're just gonna shoot him up too. Get lots of experience out of this. And we're starting to build up a surplus arrow, so it's fine. He's not dead yet because he's super tanky because he's the penguin. Oh, I did not check this rock. I don't think I did. Very foolish to go up there if I didn't. Because like I said, I got that. Oh, get out of here. We need that diamond. Very foolish not to check every rock you can. And by every rock you can, I mean every single rock. Because your overworld run will be ended by those guys. Don't think you're above them. Check the rock. Kill the wasps. Alright, I think did I do the caves? I think I did everything this run. I'll do the caves. I don't remember if I did or not. Caves already. If I didn't, we'll just do it again. Alright, got a bunch of stone arrows. Got a bunch of bone arrows. Still running short on sticks. Not getting enough sticks. Don't need any more food, don't need any more hides, because they're maxed out and all that. What kind of this iron arrows? Alright, Smelter Man, where are you? Where are you at? Need to get some more arrows off you. Exchange rate for some of these arrows is pretty poor, particularly the diamond arrows. We are very short on gold now. Or on sticks. Keep our food topped off, and then we go through here. And check the rock. It's a fake rock. Try to jump through the. Try to jump over that. Over the egg. And that was a fake rock. That would have been pretty tragic. I'm gonna be avoiding the eggs. Don't spawn too many broodmothers. So we don't fight them. Because they can come down from the ceiling and surprise us and do some damage. We don't deal with that. Although you can't fight them for easy experience, that's not what this run is for. This run is for not taking damage, which means you're taking zero risks. Kind of boring. It's a definitely different way to play the game, I feel. Alright, checked all these rocks. Let's mine them all. Should get lots of arrows from this. Notice ever since like the third level we've just been exclusively using arrows. And that's a good place to be. Just exclusively shooting arrows, everything. Broke a rock, we should be fine. A rock, an egg. I don't bother these guys because there's too many eggs around. Is that a real rock? Yes it is. Mine it. One good thing about the caves, there are no ranged enemies, so you don't need to be worried about anyone shooting you from weird angles. I don't think I hit that. Yeah, I can. All you really need to worry about are fake rocks. Why can't I pick up these arrows? This is rock real. Alright, go into the room, just check enemies. Bats are most dangerous. And anything guarding something you might want to get. Also, we need sticks. I keep forgetting we need sticks. Nothing important there for me. Diamond blade, we can get a diamond axe. So let's drop our garbage. Don't have a lot of garbage. Let's use this. Make a diamond axe, and this will make us, this will allow us to get wood much more quickly. Which is just a matter of convenience. Wood, wood, wood. Bunch of sticks. Wonderful. Clear out this area. See, that's a real rock. Shot it like 12 times. Knock, knock, knock. The district on 15. Getting a ton of sticks. Make so many arrows. Do I not have any arrows equipped? Nope. Actually, start running out of arrows. I could have gone around on this Arctic experience and avoid the dungeon at all costs. It's a scary, scary place. I think I did. Have I done every biome yet? Done multiple runs today. They're starting to run together. I think I did the dungeon in this biome. I don't know if I did the quarry. Cure of all these. All this nonsense. Make arrows. Arrows, 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 what we need. I haven't done the volcano. I'm very sure to do the volcano. Buy this diamond bar, make diamond arrows. We have no other use for our money right now. There we go, getting a good collection of arrows. It's important, especially as we approach the last level. This last level is where we're going to use a great deal of arrows. I don't know what kind of arrows this is. Bone arrow, sure. Can't have too many arrows. The belt, yep. Pretty simple place to shoot the range guys, that's your biggest threat. Otherwise there's no traps or anything. It's pretty nice casual biome. As long as you are aware of the rocks. Because there will be fake rocks. Stop jumping. Mushroom. Pew pew. These guys. It's getting pretty easy. It's starting to play itself, but you can't let your guard get down. So once that happens, you're kind of boned. Let's see what our wolf can do down here. Just push the enemy back and slightly annoy them, of course. That's what the direwolf does. It's a job. Do not want to go down there with this many mushrooms jumping around. Alright, they're all dead. So we're doing pretty well. Got all our resources, we're getting lots of arrows. Starting to gain some confidence here. We just need to go to the volcano. Pretty sure that's the biome we need to go to. We're almost certain to spawn. The volcano usually spawns kind of closer to the end of the world. Some more sticks. I don't know how many sticks we have. We have plenty of sticks. Be patient. And be careful and just take each room one at a time. Don't you dare shoot me with that. And check the rocks. Come on, Mr. Mushroom. I'm not going down there while you're down there. Just spam your arrows. Actually, out of arrows. Spam these arrows. Oh, made these jellyfish mad. So we're going back off. Too easier place to shoot them. Where'd you go? Where did anyone go? It's kind of scary. I don't know where he went. I don't think that was him. Might have been him. Shoot the rock. It's a real rock. Oh, there he is. Level 24, which isn't very high. That's fine. He said you don't need to be very high level to beat the game. In fact, level is pretty independent of your success. Alright. Last biome, I think, is the volcano. Pretty sure we went everywhere else this run. Alright, sell all this junk. Which is mostly what we have now. Junk and arrows. Which is an alright situation to be in. Gotta get all this going. More arrows, more arrows, more arrows. We're gonna use these diamond arrows on the last boss. Just because it does more damage, next go a little more quickly. Volcano, we're almost through the whole thing. Volcano's last challenge, and mostly because of the dragons. Everything else in here is pretty mild, not much of a threat. These dragons have the ranged attack. Oh no, that's not my bow. That is ranged attack, shoot their fireballs, and they also are not afraid to get very close to you, which makes it harder to dodge their ranged attacks, and they'll of course do contact damage. Actually moved ourselves off the screen right there, running away so fast. But other than the dragons, everything else is pretty harmless. These magma turtle buffaloes are pretty tanky, but they're not very threatening. They're not very aggressive. They will charge at you, like, sometimes. Double check these rocks. I don't even care if I already checked it. Those rocks mess up your run. They'll charge at you, but they're not that fast, and they don't charge at you that frequently. And they're not very threatening. Same with these little magmar dudes. They'll jump at you if you're too close. But when you have a bow, you just outrange them so badly, it doesn't matter. Now, the fireballs here are the traps. And they're not too hard to dodge. Let's make sure there's no enemies around while I try to get to the traps, though. They're much easier to dodge than the dungeon wrecking balls, for sure. It'd be a little hard to tell if they reach you, if you're, like, above them. Yeah, just look ahead, go into a new room, look for enemies. Check the rocks. Place your arrows. Let's use our bone arrows. We have a huge stack of bone arrows. Oh no, 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 no. You stop that. Always be conscientious of what's behind you in case something like that happens. You can flee safely. That applies for all the biomes, not just the volcano. There's this guy. Take out this guy. Missing the experience, but that's okay, we don't care. We don't need experience. We just need to get through without getting hit. Triple check this rock, I don't care. Can't tell you the number of times a stray fake rock has ended an overworld run. It's their favorite thing to do, that's why they exist in the game. And this exact situation is very annoying to run into. So when you have a ranged enemy in cover like this. So what we're going to do, we're going to try to just drag him out. Because he can move through the walls. He's just choosing not to, I guess. Alright, I don't think there's anything over here particularly dangerous. And now he's in the wall. Of course he's in the wall. Just go over him. There we go. And then he flies up into that wall. This is probably when dragons are most dangerous, when they're going in the walls and preventing you from shooting them. Maybe we'll dance around him. I didn't want to go and like run over here and try shooting him from here, because I don't know what's over here. This might have been another dragon. I would have just been running into danger, just putting myself in an even worse position. Oh, these guys are tanky, come on. Standing on gold deposits. Gold deposits can't be fake. Stand back and shoot them. You don't need to try anything fancy. Don't need to go too quickly. Alright, go back and mine all this. It's not really anything particularly that we can get from these treasure chests I'm worried about. I think in the volcano, the only unique thing is the filibuster, which is a good melee weapon, but we don't need it, we're not doing melee. Choose a little magmar looking dude, check the rock. Right, still going strong. That's a real rock, so we can grab it safely. Look for dragons over this trap. Keep an eye out for dragons, like I said, they're the most dangerous thing here. If you run to the black dragon, that's the boss here. He's very similar to fighting a dragon, he's just tougher. His behavior is pretty much the same, his fireball's a little thicker. He seems to be more aggressive when coming towards you, but I don't know if that's a actual objective observation or something that it feels like. And some diamond doors, don't worry about that. And we have a choice between the dungeon or the volcano. We're going back to the volcano. The volcano is way less stressful than the dungeon is. I'd rather run into a volcano, run into the black dragon in the volcano, than go into a dungeon with no skeleton king boss. It's a very large difference. This is District 20, so it doesn't matter. We're going to fight the last level now. So what does that mean? That means we get our food. We have our setup. We didn't get Rivenite Scale from that dungeon, which is a shame. But we can make a whole bunch of arrows. Which is making a ludicrous amount of arrows. Which is fine. That's what we need. That's, I don't need that. Get out of here. Alright. Sell the other junk. Sell the runoff. Arrows, 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 arrows. Get all these stacks combined. I don't know what's bone and what's not. It's bone. Put the bone in the corner. Get out of the way. Let's go in there with our large gold stack. Use that to clear out the enemies. So other than that, don't need our food anymore. We didn't make. We can make another diamond arrow. 35, not bad. Sell extra diamond. We're not gonna need any more sticks. And we need the ore, and we need our weapon, the bow. And we need the arrows. We only need like half the sticks. We probably don't even need any sticks, but just a comfortable, still moral support holding the sticks. And the most dangerous part of this is when we first get in there, and we have enemies in front of us, and the boss behind us. That's gonna be the most stressful part of this. So let's go in, immediately start shooting. Here we go. I don't even wanna bother with these first, these first crystals, because the boss is right there shooting at us, so I'm not even going to bother with it. I'm going to continue to notice I'm constantly shooting us to hit these worms, because the worms are invisible while they're underground, but their hitbox is actually still above the ground, so you can still hit them even when you can't see them. So I'm constantly shooting to make sure none of them pop out and give us a surprise and do damage. And I'm going to be shooting everywhere, because they can be anywhere. And I do not want any surprise damage from them. Shoot, shoot, shoot. Make sure no worms. Make that worm over there. Not worried about experience, it's the last level. We have our experience. We have the experience we need. It's not going to make a difference. Alright. Good thing you don't have to worry about fake rocks, though. This is the one time you don't have to check the rocks. These guys are pushover, little spear dudes. Pushovers. Just always be shooting. Just gotta make sure there's no worms around. Worms will crush your hopes and dreams. Almost as fast as the fake rocks. Probably even worse than the fake rocks, because you're this far without getting hit, and then you get hit on this last level, you're probably real disappointed. Yep, get the worms. These ranger dudes. Almost through this. Actually getting extra crystal fragments from a minor cap, which is pretty nice. Oops, that's not our pickaxe. Extra crystal fragments helps us kill a boss faster. And the less time we're in combat, the less likely we are to get hit. Shooting arrows, shooting arrows, shooting arrows, shooting arrows, shooting arrows. Just gotta make sure there's no worms anywhere. Can't be too careful. Alright. So we actually used up all of our arrows doing that, but that's no problem. Now I have a bunch of crystal fragments. Make into these light shards or whatever. We're gonna run back. We're not gonna go too fast because we don't run into his bolts. We don't wanna run into unnecessary damage. So where is he? Should be getting close. And here he is. His shots come from his mouth. So just be very aware of where that is. That's his only attack. Now we're going to shoot him. Just shoot him. That's what we're going to do. We're going to just run. Be very careful about not getting hit by his attacks. Just be overly cautious. There's nothing wrong with being overly cautious. And his attacks don't have unlimited range. And yours do. So take advantage of that. And now he's dead, and we didn't take any damage from that. Make sure you don't get hit by his final shots, because that'll count against you if you get hit before a victory screen pops up. But yeah, that's the Overworld run. You just gotta be really careful. Know the behavior of the enemies. Check all the rocks. And when you get to the last level, constantly shoot in front of you to check for the worms. And also rely a little bit on luck. And that is how you get your Overworld helm. Gotta be real careful and real slow. And can't be too cautious, don't take any risks. I hope you enjoyed the guide. And hope you come back next time.